Good afternoon. Welcome to this lunch and learn session of Xilab. It's all about technology-assisted review, the number one review accelerator today. If you have any other topics that you'd like to see addressed in our lunch and learn sessions, you can leave a message on the Xilab community, and we'll try to address these in the future. My name is Daniel Schuring. I'm product manager at Xilab. If you have any questions afterwards, you can always reach me by email at daniel.schuring@xilab.com. And today I want to talk to you about technology-assisted review. We have implemented this in Xilab already a while ago, and we've now made this part of the Xilab One eDiscovery solution. Our assisted review is based on artificial intelligence technology, specifically machine learning. And what we do with machine learning is that we try to teach the computer to recognize certain documents. And it's actually a similar approach that is being used by self-driving cars. On the screen, you see an image. And this is an image of what a self-driving car sees. And what you see on the left bottom side is actually the camera of the car, and then the larger size shows you what kind of picture is drawn by the car for driving on the road. And in order to have these self-driving cars understand the road, the engineers, they train the cars to recognize certain objects, for example, pedestrians. And what they do is that they feed the computer with all kinds of samples of pedestrians, and they try to teach the computer to understand what a pedestrian is. But also for cyclists, for road signs, and all those kinds of signs that you see in the road, the computer is being trained to recognize these. And basically, within Xilab, we use the same kind of technology, machine learning, to teach the computer what is a correct document. So, what type of document are we looking for, and are there any other documents that are similar? So, we apply the same technology, and we actually have two options here in our assisted review, which is the predictive coding. And with predictive coding, we train the system to find documents. And this is also called supervised learning, because what we do is that we feed the system with samples of proper documents, and then the machine teaches itself what to find other related documents. Next to this, we have topic modeling, and with topic modeling, the computer groups the documents together automatically, and this is unsupervised, so the computer decides for itself what documents belong to each other. Now, these technologies can be used in various situations. If you have e-discovery cases at hand and you need to review a large data set, you can train the system to find responsive documents, or you can train the system to categorize documents for certain issues, and then automatically the system will detect all the other documents that are similar. And that will save you a lot of time in reviewing large data sets. Now, we also apply this technology in data rooms for merger and acquisitions, where you need to categorize all the documents. So you can train the system to recognize certain types of documents and feed the system with some samples, and then all the other documents will also be recognized in these categories. For handling regulatory information requests, this can be used because you can quickly determine what responsive documents are. And once you've done that, the machine will automatically select more of these documents. We also see use in internal investigations. If you have certain topics you would like to investigate, or certain types of emails with certain language, then you can train the system to find these types of emails. For example, if you want to find and locate all emails about certain meetings or projects or certain arrangements, you can feed the system with some samples, and then it will find all the other related documents about the same topic. And for our Xylab, current Xylab information management platform users, it will extend your current system with a more intelligent search. You can search through large sets based on a couple of samples and find more relevant and related documents. So basically, you can actually supercharge your current Xylab information management system with the ability to find more and find easier documents. Of course, during this session, we will show you how the system will work. That's the main focus of these lunch and learn sessions. But I have a couple of more slides I want to go through. We have done a couple of tests with our clients on this, also to estimate the cost savings and the savings on all the effort that you have to do to categorize your documents. We've done one project where we classified manually 12,000 documents with 15 document types. And of these 12,000 documents, we actually found 3,500 documents responsive. So we had 15 people manually reviewing all these documents and categorizing these. And it took them about 1,500 hours to do this. And that's a full manual review. What was interesting is that we, because it was manually classified, we had a proper ground truth. So then we tried the same approach with our assisted review software. And then with one person, we were able, within about 80 hours, to classify all the documents. So that's a tremendous savings on cost and time to categorize and classify your documents. Now, the assisted review, aka predictive coding, can be used in various ways. You can use it as a search to find responsive documents, and you can use the system to continuously find documents and then tag them until we have found no documents anymore. You can also use it to train on a subset of documents, and then when you think that the quality of the system is good enough, you can automatically classify all the other documents that belong to this validation. And you can also use it for quality assurance if you already have a set of documents that are tagged and labeled. Then you can use these tags for the training purposes, and then you can see if the system can find more of these documents and see if the manual reviewer already have found anything, everything, or that there are more documents in the system that are there. Now, for assisted review, the workflow is a little bit more complex than just doing a search. There are a couple of steps in the process that you need to take care of, because we need to set up the system to start training. So when we start with the process, and let me enlarge this screen a little bit, the beginning of it. We start with the project setup, and in a project you can define which documents are part of this project. It can be a complete document set, or it can be just a part of the document set. And then in this project, what we do is create an issue. And an issue tells is about a certain topic. And for this issue, we are going to classify documents with responsive or not responsive. So we teach the computer what is a good document that belongs to this issue and what is not a good document for this issue. When we start, we first create a training set, because we need to train the computer on the documents. And we can start with a fully random training set. So it just picks some documents from your complete data set, and you will have to classify these. You can also do this based on a query, and the advantage there is that you can create a query that immediately finds some responsive documents. So you can already feed the computer with some responsive documents which will save time in teaching the system what are the correct documents. So you will sooner have much more responsive documents. In case you want to do the quality assurance, you can already use pre-coded documents. Or if you already have a data set that has some coding, you can use this coding as well. And we can also create a training set from a certain topic from the topic modeling. But I'll show you these options on screen. Then you have the option to create a validation set. And the validation set is used to measure the quality of the machine learning. And this is a complete random set that we have to tag in order to be able to compare the training that we do with the validation set. And then we can verify and report on that. Now, when we start the training, we start with a training round based on either a query, a random set, the pre-coded, or the topics. And then we start our training round. And in the training round, we get a set of documents that need to be reviewed. We tag these documents. And after the training round is finished, the system is going to calculate what are more relevant documents. And then a new round is started. And we can continue to create more and more training rounds until we're okay with the quality of our classifier. And that's something you can see in the dashboard that we have. And once you think everything is okay, then you can classify the remainder of the documents. So that's basically the workflow that we have in place. Now, with the topic modeling, like I already mentioned, we can have the generate a graph that shows you what topics are in your data set and how many documents are related to these kinds of topics. And you can use this as a starting point for creating new issues for predictive coding. So let's start with a demonstration because I think that will clarify more what we are doing. And let me go here to the assisted review dashboard. Now, what I have is a data set based on the Enron data, and I will show you later on the data set. It's about a data set with about 100,000 documents in there. And what I've created here, which you see on the left side, is two projects for this demonstration. I already created a project called Travel. And in the Travel project, I've created one issue that tries to find all documents related to travel. And I will use this later on to show you how the process goes. I also prepared here a project lunch. That's our lunch session. And also there I have a travel issue. And in there I already have done some pre-coding. So we can see how this process works. Now, let's start here a new project to show you how this works. I add here a project name, and I call this Lunch EU, because this is the European session. Then we can select here which documents we would like to include in our data set. Now, in this case, I want to include all the documents. I also would like to use topic modeling, and then I click here on create. What we do now is that now a project is started, and for the project we can define an issue. Like I mentioned, in this case I would like to find and classify all documents about travel. So I give this an issue name, travel. I can also add a description here, traveling, and then I can select here how I would like to start my initial training. I can use a random set, so it just picks a random set of documents from the system. I can do this based on a query, or I can do this based on existing tags. Now, what I will do now is I will use a query-based set, and already slightly prepared this for this. I have here a query. This is a saved search. I named it travel. And that will find a couple of documents that are related to travel. So it looks for words like travel, a flight, and so on. And this already gives me 1,000 documents. Now, I can also include here a batch size. The batch size will be 20. So I will have to train later on or tag 20 documents that are used for the training. So I will save this. Did I do this correctly? Let's use 10. Okay, this always happens in a demo. Let's use a random batch set. And click here on next. And now we can start here the project. Now what's doing now, it's now creating here a project. It's calculating all kinds of parameters from the documents to be able to train on these. We're not going to wait for this. What I already have done is that I've prepared here a project called with the travel, L travel, that's the issue name. And in my review system, and this is the new Xylab One eDiscovery review system, I can go here to my documents. And it will load here all my facets. And at the bottom, I have here a set of documents that I will need to review. It's called the Lunch and L Travel document set. And if I click here, I've got here a list of documents that I need to label. Now, I already did this in advance because it doesn't make any sense to go to over 20 documents to start training on this. But if you see here, for example, the document here, let me open up the document here. This is, for example, a document about all kinds of headlines for the news. And in green, I already have some highlights there from my query, which is like words like visit and city, special. And you see I've labeled this already with not responsive for this issue. I also have some responsive documents. This is about a flight that is taking place. And there are some more responsive documents here about flights and pricing of those. So I already prepared this batch by classifying these 20 documents. And now what I can do now is, if I go to my issue here, I can create here a new batch. And what you see here that I already completed 163 documents, of which 35 are responsive. And if I create a new batch size here, what will happen now is that it will take these documents, it will start training on these documents, and present me with a new batch of documents that I need to review for another training session. So that is what is happening now. It's training the system and will present me with a new list of documents. Now, while we're waiting for this, what we also have is the topic modeling. And what you see here in the topic modeling is that we have a circle diagram which shows you all the topics that we have created, or that the system has created automatically. So if I double click, for example, on one of these sections, it will open up and it will show you the subtopics under these, under the main one. So if we zoom in on outages, you will see the words that are most common or that mostly occur Those will be highlighted in the facet. You can also display this as a tree list. Now you will have another view of these documents. And what you can do if you select here a topic, you see on the right hand side, you see here that you can create an issue from this topic, and then you also can start doing the modeling or the training of the system. So let's go back to the assisted review progress. This is now completed. And what you see here is that we also have a couple of curves about the first training round and our recall. Now we can continue this because I've now in my review system, I've got here a new batch if I refresh these documents. You will see that I have got a new result list which has not been tagged yet. And if I open up the system or the document, I can now see that I have this document is about traveling. And it's about booking flights and all that kind of stuff. So I can label this as this is a responsive document. And I can continue now to do the training, and you will see that these are all documents now about travel. And I keep on labeling these documents until I'm finished. You see already, based on the first training set, I had only a few documents that were related to travel. The system is now feeding me back all kinds of other documents about traveling. I have one project that for which I've done some more training rounds. You can see here how many training rounds we have been doing, and the lunch session is now the first one. But already have prepared this one with 7 training rounds. And then you see that I've completed 211 documents. I've found 176 responsive documents. You see that my precision and recall is pretty high. We also have some graphs for you to indicate what the quality is of the classifier. For example, the gain curve shows you how many documents are being responsive and how many we have reviewed. So in this one we have reviewed about 141 documents, and 106 documents are responsive. You see that this is actually a pretty steep curve, so that's actually pretty good. Another indicator for the quality of the machine learning is the precision of the return set, where we see how many documents that the system is giving us back for training are relevant. And you see that first we only have a few relevant documents, and then after the first training we have a very high. Then the system comes back with some documents which were not relevant, so we end relevant, and then the system is picking up again, finding all the relevant documents. So these are very important for the indication of the quality. So let's go back to the presentation. The main benefit of TAR is that it will save you time and cost, but it also increases the quality. And you can do you can faster label documents, large set of documents, using the machine learning that we have in place. And that saves you a lot of time, especially if you work with deadlines and don't have enough people available. You can really speed up the progress of labeling documents and tagging documents. Of course, if you save time, you also save cost, and you can do with less people, you can do more. But also in many cases, we see that the quality of the machine learning outperforms the manual reviewers. So also the quality of labeling your documents is increasing a lot. So this concludes the lunch and learn session. I don't know if there are any questions. I see a question here about range. But the question is not really clear about the range. Will check later on the questions. If there are no more questions at this moment, then I will end this presentation. The presentation will be posted on the Xylab community, where you can view the recording and share this with your colleagues. If you have any questions in the meantime, let us know. You can communicate through us through the community or directly by email. Thank you very much for attending, and have a nice day.